All right, good day. Raincity Chronicles rolling on here again. We're down in Chinatown. Dave O, Roland Tanglao, Richard Erickson, Silly Guaylo. And where are we?
We are at the Boss. One of the finest Cantonese, I guess what you'd call working style cafes in Chinatown. Next to you, there's also Newtown Bakery, which is kind of more of a down market version.
Well, you saw that in a previous episode too. You know, here in Chinatown, it's loaded with cafes, right? But you know, you gotta have some savvy veterans with you, like these guys, to figure out really what the best places to go in and stop.
We've been around. We've eaten here many times with the legendary Andy Smith, author of the first implementation of OWASP.
Wow.
A master coder when he worked for Skip.
Wow, that's some serious geek references.
Also a master coder when he worked for Jaiku and Google.
And he works for Jaiku, which was acquired by Google.
Wow. Well, you've certainly stated your credentials then.
That's right. We lunch with the best.
And you showed your knowledge of the menu by ordering us a fine variety of food that's on its way. But what I've been working on this morning there at the office, because we don't spend the whole day out goofing around, is I'm starting to get ready for Northern Voice. And the buzz is starting. It's exciting. Northern Voice is sold out. Moose Camp, I think there's still a few spaces left.
Okay. 2008 at northernvoice.ca.
And if you sign up for Moose Camp, you get to go and see you guys present. You guys are doing the internet boot camp, social media boot camp series?
That's right.
Yeah, let me explain. It's an unconference, which means that all of the sessions are scheduled on the day of. This year we add this a scheduled track for people who are new to social media.
Yeah, so you don't have to be one of these Uber geeks to show up and do this.
And that's scheduled. It's called Internet Bootcamp. And the great thing is, the law of two feet applies. You can leave. If you're a beginner in video blogging, which I'm presenting, or a beginner in blogging, you can attend our session, but you can mix and match. You can take the Internet Bootcamp sessions that interest you, plus the ad hoc sessions organized the day of that you can lead or participate in.
Or you can hang out with me in the lobby while I'll be frantically finishing my presentation.
Richard's doing Blogging 101.
You did that last year too, didn't you?
I did that last year. Last year I had a little bit more time. I think I had 45 minutes last time. This year I have
Constraints are good.
This year I have half an hour, so I'm going to be going through quite a bit. I did my outline yesterday, and it's about a day's worth of material.
WordPress into FTW for beginning bloggers.
Packed into half an hour. Oh, here's our drink.
Dong Lai Cha and Richard Spice. I mean, love Coca-Cola.
No, never happened. This is not mine.
It's an outrage. So, but you can do it, Richard, eh?
I can do it, yeah. I'll probably spend 20 minutes talking and then 10 minutes saying that people can come over and ask me questions, and I'm sure people will. People have been asking me questions all year, ever since my talk last year.
Yeah, and you know, your blog, you're a little cynical and keep on threatening to stop blogging.
Yeah, that's true.
I personally will put out the claim publicly for you to keep blogging, because I really like the insights you bring on some of my favorite topics. Yeah. We're both transit geeks in the international culture, and you know, a bit of this internet stuff, you know.
Yeah. Well, my blog has I think I have a little bit of a reboot in the last month or so. I've been reading books more, which means I've been spending a lot more time thinking linearly instead of kind of all crazy land and kind of weird spaces. So now I'm a little bit more focused in my writing. So I think it's been a bit of a.
Can you give us a sneak peek? Are you going to be applying the things you've been socially bookmarking? About the presentation, which has been bookmarking materials on how to be a better presenter.
Yeah, that's true. I'm not a very good presenter.
He's fine. He's awesome.
But I'm
also modest.
But I'm improving on every presentation, so it's not like I'm not learning. So.
Yep. Well, you got the skills to pay the bills, man. Roland, you're doing some kind of video blogging. And now I saw you do, you know, my first Northern Voice, I saw you do your presentation when you tried to import 8,000 high-res images to put together a slideshow on the fly or something like
that. Yes, I tried and it failed because it crashed the computer. Wow. Talking about presentation savvy.
Something will go wrong.
Together with the incomparable Jordan Behan and professional video man Warren Frey, Jordan, we will be presenting Video Blogging 101 as part of the bootcamp. Like Richard, blogging 101, we only have 30 minutes. So we are basically throwing everything onto the wiki, wiki.northernvoice.ca. So all the details are going to be on the wiki. We're just going to try to give you a flavor, an idea, an overview. No need to stress out. We're going to put the entire presentation, including all the details, onto the wiki page. We just want you to get a sense of what video blogging is, and why you want to do it, and how to do it.
I have no idea what video blogging is, why anyone would want to do it.
As Eric Rice says, shout out to Eric, video is a whole spectrum of expression, just like text. There's anything
like text,
from
like
dumping it, streaming it live with an archive like we do with Quick, just doing a quick thing with your webcam, or like we're doing with our digital still camera, up until heavily produced with awesome production values like Lab with Leo.
Yep.
Or you could even put CGC programs on. So it's a huge spectrum, but basically it's something that's compelling to a lot of people these days, and it is. It's its own medium. You can't evaluate it from a text point of view. They're both great, text and video.
It's easier than it was 10 years ago, and it's easier than it was 5 years ago to publish your bands and rates.
All you need is
100 and text. And
yeah, I had the first version of Real Audio and Real Video. I know that it's a lot easier now.
So in 2008, all you really need is an internet connection and a digital still camera. That's kind of your
intro. No. There's one more thing that you need. Something interesting to say.
Ah, well, you always need something interesting to say.
Yeah.
Wow.
Got this here, internet?
Yeah. Basically, for $200 in Canadian, including tax, you have a decent video recorder in your digital still camera to take videos. Any brand these days is good. And then you need a computer and internet connection.
Yep.
Done. And you go to blip.tv, or our favorite, or also to YouTube and any of the other video sharing sites.
There's a heap of them for sure.
Now, but that segues into sort of the discussion about, you have to have something to say, sort of segues into what Dave's presentation. He'll be on the stage after Matt Mullenweg is giving a keynote on Saturday.
Yeah, so, I think I'm batting third. I think there's, is it Marc, is Marc Canter now?
Right, so we've got, yeah, we've got Matt Mullenweg talking about the future of social media.
Press, social media, right. You know, young, youthful.
And then saxophone player, jazz guy.
Yeah, then Marc Canter, who started Macromedia, if I recall correctly.
That's right,
and
Adobe. Yeah, Macromedia, which became Macromedia.
But Marc is a crazy visionary thinker, and the guy is a wildfire, man. He's a hoot, and so I think it'll be some good entertainment there.
He's a hooter.
And then I'll have the dubious honor of following those two A-listers.
Dubious honor.
Hey, yeah. Enough of that, kids. Talking about the importance of having something to say, about that we have this opportunity to make art, right? We have all these tools. Imagine the monks back there diligently transcribing books, or the artists painting, you know, corporate generals and angels on the ceiling, because that's all they were allowed to make. Now we have the opportunity to make anything we want for art. So
what's the title of your talk, dude?
It's called Fuck Stats, Make Art.
Okay, now we're going to have to change the rating on the blip to PG.
But
language.
I really think it should have a subtitle of, no, really, Dave, tell us more about you. I think is, so I'm going to come across as a self-absorbed dork, I think, but aside from that, it should be pretty entertaining.
Well,
last year I did one on podcasting that you guys helped
me out. Bob Dylan, kind of flick-card style. Yeah, you know, that classic video of Dylan in the 60s. Dave is very modest, just like Richard. Well, I'm not as modest as Richard, but... basically, Dave blew us away last year, and it all comes down to, like, you can talk about monetization, and perhaps you should think about things, you can talk about traffic, you can talk about all these things, but really what it comes down to is making art, or having a voice. That voice can be done through text, that voice can be done through audio, pictures,
all
whatever.
Sorts of medium.
You gotta do what you gotta do, and if there's no compelling... what would be narrative or reason for you doing it, you're not going to do it.
Indeed. Well, so if you haven't signed up for Northern Voice, you're basically out of luck unless you want
to
get on
Moose
the wait
camp.
List.
I think there's like two or three spots left.
If you're kind of a rebel, you can just kind of show up and hope for the best. But out at UBC, our last show, we talked about some of the transportation foibles.
More food.
More food. All right, we've got some food to eat, so you're gonna have to let yourself out. So just throw yourself out the front door, won't you? Roland, Richard, say bye to the nice people.
Ciao, cheers, Sai Chen.
See ya.